Well, Rick, I'm looking forward to today because I already took a sneak peek and saw that you brought the Rubicon Trail.
Yes.
And this is a cool trail and one that I have to admit, I've never been on. Well, and I think it's got to be beautiful.
It is. But I think the main attraction is that it is not the roughest four-wheel drive trail or ATVs, because motorcycles, everybody can go across this. But it is definitely the most famous.
Well, is there ever a time that you can go on it when it isn't packed with people?
I mean, the Jeeper Jamboree that runs across there will pack it with people. Mark Smith, USA, does trips across there with Jeep dealers from other countries. And so you can find a lot of people.
Well, yeah, because you got Toyota, is it called the Rubathon? There's a Toyota group that does it.
Yeah, and there's the Pirates of the Rubicon. I mean, there are a lot of different clubs.
Because we've tried several times with ATVs to set up a time to go up there, and there was always a big event going on.
It's the most famous.
Yeah, I guess that's what you get.
Now, what we did in my videos, I got a group of guys together. We're going through the little sluice here, and I brought 8 Jeeps and 2 Hummers.
Oh.
Because I wanted to kind of show that Hummers could get across that trail as well. And then when we got to Buck Island Lake, a guy with some that rents, in fact, he still does. Somebody else owns the company, but they rent four-wheel drive quads. ATVs that you can go down and rent them, and he'll take you on the Rubicon. And we met him at Buck Island Lake. He camped with us and finished the trail in the morning with us.
Oh,
so that way I was trying
to a good little mix of
have a good
and ATVs and Hummers. And
right,
Hummers didn't have any problems with their width.
No, and you know the guy who drove his Hummer, it was his personal Hummer. He drove through the little sluice. He put one little scratch in it, I think, but. Oh. You know, it's pretty easy to do. Now, on the side of a little sluice, all those people stand up there.
Yep.
On a normal weekend, it'll be jammed with people, and you're going to get a lot of hecklers. People will start yelling out to you, do you have a driver's license?
No.
Or how'd you make it this far?
Now, these are all other Jeepers that have been on the trail. They're up there doing that trail for the weekend.
Or they went around it. And they wouldn't dare go through there.
Oh.
And they're setting over there heckling anybody who goes through.
So there's plenty of ways to get around. So is it true? You know, Jeep makes this comment that you can take one of their Grand Cherokees or a Boxstock Wrangler through this trail. Is that true?
And they do, but not without damage.
Oh, okay.
You've got to have a rocker panel protection below the door, and you need to get 31-inch tires on it.
Okay.
Now, a lot of times when Jeep will bring something through there, I also see a lot of people out there. They call them spotters, but another name for them is rock rollers.
I see.
Because they roll rocks into the holes.
They move everything around.
So if you want to run the Rubicon Trail and have it the roughest, then go through it right after they open the trail in the after the winter or the spring, really. And then the rocks have moved around and the trail will be the roughest.
Okay.
If you want to run it when it's easiest, run it after the Jamboree goes through there in July in the first week
of August.
A lot
of rocks put in place. But I could do it in a stock Wrangler.
You can.
A TJ.
Just get 31s and rocker panels.
Or like our Project XJ.
Yes.
Just do it in that.
Right.
Do I need lockers?
No.
Don't need lockers. Could just do it with careful driving.
It's just a technical trail.
And don't drink.
Right. Except at night.
That's right. I see that causes a lot of mistakes on trails. It's a little bit too much to drink.
I think it causes a lot of breakage.
Yeah, there you go.
But great trail. Now, this is another part of the trail that they don't run on the Jamboree. This is part of the original trail. And the Jeep Jamboree is in a hurry to get to Rubicon Springs.
Many people.
Right. And they can't camp. The Forest Service would never give them a permit. To park 300 Jeeps somewhere.
So if we're taking a small group, there's a lot of side trails and places that we can go. Other than this. Are they all marked pretty well?
No.
No.
But I do make a map.
Hey, that's a good idea. So if I go to do that, get your map first.
I recommend it.
All right. Hey, thanks again. That was a good trail. I like this one.
Thanks, Doug.